control. Probably getting a signal.
Are you on your way?
Next to you.
So you just drove all the way up here so you could wait in the dark and yell boo? Real mature.
Something like that.
Oh, wow.
I'm moving up here.
What?
It's gone stir crazy since I sold the company. I need something to do. I mean, plus, do you have any idea how much faster this place is going to get done if we move up here full time?
Yeah. You here alone by yourself every day? You're going to go nuts. We set up full time? Seriously?
You are the most perfect person for me. And when I picture my life, and I picture the future, there's no version that doesn't have you. I promise. Wherever fate may take us, together. Will you marry me?
You just going to the hardware store?
Yeah, you need me to pack something up?
No, just thought you might need your, what do you want?
A little closer.
Tell me why.
Tugger, how you doing?
Hey, man. How are you?
I got that stuff for you. Are you still plugging away at that old rat trap up there?
Yeah, I'm actually moving up there
full-time
pretty soon.
Really? Funny, you don't look suicidal, but hey, everyone needs a hobby, right? See, do you know Woody? Woody, this is Doug. He just bought the old Hageman Mansion up there.
Hageman Mansion? True story. That Hageman widow, she was one of the first serial killers.
Oh, yeah, the urban legend.
It's not a freaking legend. Ilsa Hageman brought over young maids from Ireland and killed them in her basement. Get the hell out of there.
Okay.
Yeah. She put a curse on that place. It sucks you in, gets a hold of you.
Thanks for the drama, Woody. TJ's got that stuff on the back dock. Why don't you go take a look?
Listen to me.
I'm so sorry to bother you with this. I'm just not mechanically inclined. And I walked out without my cell phone. This is like the last thing that I needed.
Your dad never taught you to change a tire?
No.
Well, come watch me do this. It's good to know in case you get stranded somewhere without a handsome stranger to help you out.
Yeah, for you. Seriously, though. Thank you.
Doug.
Jamie.
I'm sorry.
So you live up at the big old farmhouse, right?
You a cop?
No, I go jogging there every day. I've seen you out working a couple of times.
Yeah, it's really just a weekend fixer-upper for us right now.
Oh, are you...
You're done.
Thank you so much.
No worries.
Here. So what do I owe you?
First visit's free.
No, seriously.
Don't worry about it. Just repay the favor someday.
Well, thanks again.
You didn't learn anything there, did you?
I could, lie to you.
Take care. Long enough.
Screw took a while, huh?
Yeah, I had to stop and help a girl with a flat on the way back.
Oh, yeah? Little damsel in distress?
Aren't they all?
No.
Hey, we're gonna be late. Lori, you ready? Gotta get going.
I'm putting my shoes on.
So tell me, how's that little shack in the woods? Seriously, I still don't know why you bought that shovel. Get away from you. Oh my god, that's totally such a ballad thunder. Look at this, the blushing bride. How you doing? Mwah. So tell me everything that happened. Did he do a good job with the proposal? Did he do the rose petals? Cause that was
that's next week.
Well, okay, you know what? Look, it's not too late, okay? We can run away together, get a little place on the islands, just you and me.
Let me see it. Hey, Nay. Round cut, good clarity. Classic. Good job. Tomorrow we'll go to Dupree's, make sure it ain't Fugazi. Hey, Nay.
That's 60, yummy.
Yams
and yams. I know, and I love you, yams.
Oh, my God. Please, for the rings, amigo.
Oh, you're doing the Heisman.
Yeah,
you're
I'm totally... actually, there's something missing.
Oh, is that right? Yes, there is something missing, actually. It's the food. You guys ready to eat? I thought we were just grabbing drinks. No. I got us a table. Come on. Right this way. Come right along. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to announce our newly engaged friends, Doug and Lori. All right. There you go. Of course. Absolutely. And don't forget about you. Doug, Lori, may the joy that you feel today only be a fraction of what's to come. And as they say in the old country, here is to our wives and our girlfriends. May they never meet! Cheers!
Wait. We need a picture. Oh, give us something good! Kiss her! Let's see the ring. I kind of barn and surprised you.
He did. It was really cute.
Back.
What?
Ellen, what is he doing here? Did you invite him?
We were talking about the surprise party at
college. No, you didn't tell him. He overheard. I know that he's coming for
peace. Hey, there she is.
Mwah. Ellen, what are you doing here?
What? I can't come by to congratulate you? You know, you could have invited me.
Please leave.
Relax. Listen, I just wanted to see you, okay? I just wanted to... Oh, hey! The lucky guy! What's going on? Congratulations.
Please don't.
Oh, he's scrappy. Why are you here, Ellen? Well, I just wanted to say congratulations.
I mean, the course of true love never did run smooth at all. You have a lovely bride. And Lori, well, could have been with a future congressman. But instead, But I understand the two of you acquired a nice little fixer-upper in the country. Well,
hey. Is everything okay here? Yeah. Alan was just leaving.
Yes, so I was. Lori, when this whole thing falls apart, and it will, you look me up. Doug. Joke.
You want to talk about it?
I thought that was over.
It is. It's been over. It was never really even a thing in the first place.
Really? Because those text messages I saw sure made it seem like a thing.
Seriously, Doug, I thought we were past this. It was a year ago. Nothing happened. It was just some text messages. I don't know what else I can do. I fucked up. I'm sorry. And I know it's not an excuse, but you were completely wrapped up in work. How long are you gonna punish me for this?
I don't know. How long will your ex-boyfriend be showing up at our engagement parties?
Please don't be like this.
I don't want to be. You think I like being this way?
I love you. We're getting married. Doesn't that count for anything?
I don't know.
Do you trust me? Doug, do you trust me?
Yes.
Much more packing.
Just this in the bedroom.
The bedroom was packed. But don't go up there. Just stay in my place for a while. But you go out to the house and you're gonna be surrounded by nothing but her.
And I'm not now?
What about the therapy? You know, for your injury.
I'm fine. What I don't need is a bunch of people looking at me with pity.
Yeah, well, come on. It wasn't your fault. It was an accident. I know that you feel terrible, but you can't dwell on it. You have to move forward. You can't just live in the past.
I'm not living in the past. It's only been 6 weeks. I just want to finish the house the way Lauren wanted.
Hey, man, look. I mean, we all miss Lori.
Hello? Someone there? just need to get out of the house.
I'll start crazy. What can I get you?
Scotch and soda.
Heard about your lady. Condolences. How's the house? Seen anything yet?
Like what? That the old lady?
She was a nurse in the Civil War. After the war, she come back here. Her whole family's gone. Husband, father, dead in the war. Mother, sister died of influenza. She took over the big house, shut down the farm. She placed ads for servants in the newspapers in Ireland. People could see the girls at the train station. They'd go up to the house to work, and poof, nobody ever sees them ever again.
Last call?
Yeah.
So what happened to the service?
He worked for a while. And one night when they're sleeping, she comes at him with ether. They wake up in the basement. She keep him locked up in there so she could hear him screaming. And when she felt like it, when she heard enough, she had this gas tap she installed. She'd turn it on. Listen until the screaming died out.
How do you know so much about this?
My brother used to own that house.
Really? I'd love to talk to him about it. What?
He died. 1970 in that house.
Sorry to hear that.
In the middle of the night, his teenage daughter took an axe, killed him, killed my sister-in-law as they slept, killed her little sister. Used a shotgun on herself.
God.
That house took control of his mind. My niece was an angel the day they moved into that house. But in a couple of months, she was different. Right hand to God. That house is what made her.
Hello?
cannot.
Yeah. Please don't ever do that again.
How's the work coming up here?
Good. So far, so good.
Good. Well, you know, maybe it'd be a good idea then to get away for a while. You know, maybe get back in the game. I got a couple deals cooking. I want to get this done. I can't leave it. What's this? A gift. A grad student lives down the street. Really? It's not like that.
I helped her with a flat tire.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, that's good. That's good. It's good to make some friends up here and just someone to talk to. Who are you?
Jesus, you scared me to pieces.
Who are you?
Keep quiet to wake her. Please, help me. She's going to kill me, I know it. For the love of God, find someone to help me. I just wanted to see if you got the pie I made you. I'm so sorry. How did it? I mean,
car accident.
Oh my God, that's horrible. So why are you up here all alone? Shouldn't you be with your family?
My mom passed away. My dad. Who knows where he is?
It's hard when you lose someone young. It's like you have to mourn the life you're going to have together.
Sometimes I feel like she's still here.
That's totally normal.
Is it? Doesn't feel normal. Feels like my mind's playing tricks on me.
You should spend time with other people.
That's what Connor says.
Yeah. And too much time alone, you get stuck up in your head. Your brain becomes like a maze.
So what about you? What's your deal?
Well, I get my master's degree in May. Family therapy.
Just the person I needed to be talking to.
Yeah, right. So, what do you do?
Before the accident, I was in finance. Yeah, we basically bought the entire estate as is. Pretty impulsive, I guess.
Really? Of these old buildings, the history? I live here, I'd never want to leave. So when will you be finished with all the restoration?
I don't know. A while.
I'm talking too much, I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. Listen, I feel like I need to tell you something. I appreciate you coming over here with the pie and everything. And I don't know what you're thinking, but I need to let you know that I'm not interested in any sort of dating or relationship or anything.
No, look, I'm not in any way capable of dating anyone right now. Just thought we could, you know, be friends. You seem like you could use someone to talk to. And I probably could too. I should get going. I want to get a run in before it gets dark.
Thanks again for the pie.
No problem.
Hey, wait. I think I really could use a friend. What's real anymore?
Are you okay?
Lori?
Connor. It's Doug. I don't know. He's talking to himself.
Doug.
Connor? What is it?
What do you call it here?
America.
You're fine. Look, I'm coming out there.
Don't. I'm fine. Just go back to sleep.
I'm not stalking you or anything. You okay?
Yeah, I just... I don't know what's wrong with me.
Listen, if I have to eat dinner alone one more night, I'm gonna go nuts. Let me cook dinner for you tomorrow night, around 5. Do us both some good.
I couldn't ask you.
That's why I'm asking you. I'll take that as a yes. Why you killed me? Stay away from him! She's late.
I'm sorry about today.
Where were you?
I was home. I heard you.
Oh.
I wouldn't have been a very good host.
Why?
I was thinking about Lori.
Anyway,
I just wanted to apologize. I hope you weren't too upset.
I poured my angst out into my diary. I'll get over it.
If you still wanted to come by, I'm free tomorrow.
I promise to answer the door this time.
Your turn to sweat.
So you've actually seen her. Who would have?
I don't know. Maybe.
I mean, it could be a lot of things. You've been through so much stress. You're cooped up there all alone.
This old guy, Woody. He thinks the place is haunted. Man, it's putting thoughts in my head.
Oh. You know what? I got an idea.
Great.
Here's what we're gonna do. Slumber party. We stay up all night, wait for the ghost to come out. It'll be fun.
Every time it rains.
Place looks great.
Sure, by candlelight.
How's the renovations going?
It's slow. A lot of work.
So, ghosts. Where are we looking? Seriously? Down here. Oh my God. Could you have a creepier basement?
So what about you?
What do you mean?
Well, you don't talk about yourself much.
Picked up on that, huh? I don't like to talk much about my personal stuff.
Yeah, I kind of got that. It's cool, I mean, you're here to try to help me figure out if my house is haunted, so. We all have issues.
I need to be more open with you. Or like in general. Let's just say I'm attracted to the wrong type of guy. I grew up in Arizona. My dad was a contractor. Sometimes, mostly he sold drugs. Coke, meth, oxy. My mom tried to take care of us, but I think she was from an abusive family. In any case, she was in an abusive marriage. He beat her. Beat me up. And begged us to forgive him. I'm sure you know chapter two, a series of fucked up boyfriends, constant search for a new daddy, which always ended in a substitute that was just as bad as the original. And then I met the total package. Addiction, uneducated, emotionally abusive, physically violent. One day, I didn't want to do it anymore. I stood up to him. Came after me with a kitchen knife. That's when I decided to leave.
I have something I need to tell you. Your car accident. Lori. We're having an argument. Driving fast, angry. I should have known better. Just wanted you to know that. That it was my fault.
You can forgive yourself. Lemon or cream?
I don't care.
Something wrong? I get it. It was too soon. Maybe I should go. Of course I should go, obviously.
I'm changing the plans. Get out of here. That's it. What do you think? This will be the baby's room. What?
It's all gonna work out, isn't it?
Smell the manure through the phone.
I'm in the middle of something.
What, are you blowing me off already?
Look, listen, man. Like, I'm worried about you.
Why don't you just come into Philly? You stay with us, you forget about the house for a while.
I don't want to forget about the house.
No, I didn't mean it that way. I just meant that you...
You don't get it. So let me spell it out for you.
This house means everything to me.
I am never leaving this house.
Okay. Sorry. Well, then when can I come out and see what you're doing?
you. I don't care if this isn't real.
I remember the last time you made love to me in this bed. Look at me.
No!
Why did you do that? You needed to see the truth.
The truth.
If you wanted to be with me, then why did you kill me?
It was an accident.
You want me to leave, don't you?
Hey, it's me. I know this phone call should have come sooner. But here goes. I got scared that morning. You were right. You're the only one I can talk to. I think I'm going crazy. This house is tormenting me. I'm seeing things. Lori. I need help. Thank you.
Doug, what are you doing?
You won't return my calls.
Figure it out.
I'm sorry about what happened, okay?
Doug, I heard all this before.
Jamie.
I can't.
I know I'm screwed up. I've been having some problems, and I am begging you for your help. I'm sorry. Nothing, I just think you should go.
No.
What?
No. I'm not leaving you. You're grieving. You can't keep pushing people away. Make her leave, Doug.
Don't tell me what to do.
I'm not telling you what to do. I'm trying to help you.
I don't need your help. I need to be left alone.
No, you don't. I'm not leaving you. You need someone to stay with you. You've lost so much, Lori.
Lori didn't mean me.
I don't mean it that way, Doug. You suffer a tremendous amount of pain. I think the baby is sick.
What?
You're suffering.
Would you stop trying to psychoanalyze me?
I'm not trying to pressure you. I'm here for you. Whatever you need, I just don't think you should be alone.
Yeah!
Lori. Jamie?
Jamie, leave a message.
Hey Jamie, it's Doug. Please call me. Call me, text my cell, anything. Just let me know you're okay. I brought you something. Why are you here? I was just checking in on you. I just wanted to give you this, and it was all I could think of. Checking in? Like I'm too incompetent to take care of myself?
Doug, no one's heard from you. You're all alone up here.
I want to be alone. Look, if you ever get yourself together again, give me a call sometime. I'd love to catch up with my friend. Like, it's a question, like, you don't know if you're real?
stay with me. Stay with us.
I know it's hopeless to try to reach you. I just want to let you know you've meant a lot to me. I don't want you to feel guilty for what I'm about to do. I've tried everything I can think of. I just don't see any answers. This needs to end. Maybe this way everyone can be happy. Anyway, thank you.
What's gonna happen?
It'll be cold at first. Dark.
Then what?
And then I'll find you. I didn't want to leave you here all alone. I wanted to help. I was afraid I couldn't do anything for you.
Hey man, I just wanted to apologize about our conversation the other day.
It's no problem. Is everything okay?
That's what I wanted to tell you. I'm doing a lot better. I think I'm gonna get through this.
Woody!
Anyways, I just wanted to say I appreciate it, man.
Yeah, sure.
I just wanted to let you know I'm getting out of that house.
You okay? I'm
selling it.
Good for you. Screw over some other poor bastard.
to probably go to class.
You're gonna learn about crazy people?
Yeah.
You know, you probably learn a lot more by staying here.
Oh. Well, look who got funny. Is that a joke?
No.
Are you making jokes now, Doug?
No. I'm not funny. I'm depressed.
Maybe class can wait.
Hey, I got your keys. You know, most people around here don't carry pepper spray.
Oh, yeah? Well, maybe I'll get rid of it.
Call me after class?
Do you enjoy reality, Doug?
Nothing. I think you should go.
No!
What?
No, I'm not leaving you. Don't you see? This is what you did last time. You're grieving. You can't keep pushing people away.
Don't tell me what to do.
I'm not telling you what to do. I'm trying to help you.
I don't need your help. Need to be left alone.
No, you don't. I'm not leaving you. You need someone to stay with you. You've lost so much. Lori.
Don't say her name! This will be the baby's room.
It's all gonna work out, isn't it?
can see my breath exhaled. The dawn is so bright.